Apple is, you know, according to our data, your second biggest customer. What would a possible Apple Intel tie-up mean to you guys?
Look, there's no relationship, and actually, it has been widely reported for years now that over the next few years, I think Apple will stop, you know, getting chips from Qualcomm, and the company has really moved on not only what we're doing within the Android ecosystem, but we're now in PCs, in automotive, in industrial, in robots. We're even into the data center. So Qualcomm, it's a different company right now. We continue to execute on this strategy, and there's really no relationship.
But in terms of a tie-up, do you think that's even something likely, that there is some deeper relationship between those two companies?
The way I think about it, and like, I don't know details, but I can only see two possible angles. One possible angle is Intel continue to invest to become a foundry. In that case, you know, as we are a fabless company, we welcome more foundries. Today, we manufacture our chips with TSMC, with Samsung, and if Intel has the capability to become a competitive foundry in America, we're very happy, and we will look at them as a manufacturer. As far from a product standpoint, I can't really see a connection because Apple have their own processors.
And we want to get on to other stuff. One more question, though. How are you feeling about the government investing in Intel? I don't know, would it be fair for other companies, even a Qualcomm, to say, wait, you know, what about us?
Look, my understanding of this is there is an overarching strategic topic, which is manufacturing of semiconductors. And I think we know, and it's been widely reported, that, you know, Intel had a struggle to compete with companies like TSMC and Samsung. So anything that is driven towards enhancing the industry manufacturing capability, especially in the United States or even other places, so we have a more geographically diversified manufacturing, that's actually good news. We're looking at the big picture.
Cristiano, like, the thing definitively that's changed is the landscape in both PC and mobile. But I really want to start on the PC bit. I look at what's come out of Maui, generation to generation from a year ago. And what's really clear is you want to push even deeper into Windows-based PC. Could you just explain, like, how the generational updates on the tech help you do that and why it's important?
Yes, I wish you all here with us. This is actually not a place.
We wish we were there also.
Yes, this has been day three of a lot of announcements, all the chip announcements. And one thing that we're actually very proud, I think, as I said, you know, earlier to Carol, I think the company is diversifying. We're building products for many different industries, and PCs is one of the growth vectors of the company. So we announced our second generation PC. We just entered this market. And in our second generation, I think people are seeing one of the biggest leaps in performance from generation to generation. We have 40% improvement in the CPU, 80% improvement in the GPU, and we actually have the very first processor in a thin and light laptop and running at 5 gigahertz of clock frequency. But the real news is the amount of AI performance. I think the transition of phones and PCs to AI is happening, and those are what those chips are designed to do.
Cristiano, I don't want to make statements because, like, I'm the journalist, and as you know, I love to ask you questions, but I go very deep on what's happening. And so, like, there's an acceptance that this is edge technology that's deployed in the real world. But I kind of want to hold you to how it's going. You know, in February, you basically said that in really specific category, you know, Windows PC priced $800 and above, I think you said you had 10% market share in that. And I'm looking at the specifics of what came out of Maui in the last 3 days. Do you have an update on the ownership you have in that market, or what this latest gen of chipsets will do to push you deeper into it?
Yes, this is a great question. We are, you know, as we're new in this market, and it has been, you know, it's actually, we can leverage a lot of technology. It's actually accretive, I think, to Qualcomm. And we're tracking to what we said. We actually only launched this, you see PCs with our chips in the United States in the top five European markets, and we're tracking about 9% right now. I think our projection was by 2029 to get to about 12%, very reasonable. But what is exciting right now, and that's, I think, in your question, is the edge AI transition is happening. Actually, the foundational models now are being designed so they have cloud and edge working side by side. And that is actually creating an opportunity for us to accelerate. And it is reflected in a number of designs. We actually, you know, a while ago, just a couple quarters ago, we talked about having 100 designs across all the major PC OEMs, HP, Dell, Lenovo, Acer, ASUS, Samsung. Now that number is significantly higher, and we're seeing the excitement.